Okay, well, we're going to get started. It's 7 o'clock and December 11th. First of all, I want to say that I hope it didn't throw people off, but over the last couple of months, we've had a couple of things. One, Thanksgiving weekend. I looked at the calendar of the Christmas and New Year's. All our Christmas is going to be on a Sunday, I believe. So instead of trying to work th throughout the holidays, that's why we're having this meeting on December 11th. And I think the last one we had, we threw it was off because of Thanksgiving. And also, Mr. Dudley's gala was celebrated on the last Sunday of October. So we just kind of changed things up a little bit. But in January, we will be going back to the last Sunday of the month for the meeting to be consistent. So after today, beginning in January, it'd be the last Sunday of the month. It won't have another meeting over the holidays. But the last Sunday in January, we'll have another meeting update to get back on track with the last Sunday of each month. So I just wanted to get that out the way and let everyone know why we're doing it on the 11th today, but not on the last Sunday of the month. Anyway, my name is Jimmy Davies and founder of Every Dot Black. And so a few things that we cover before we actually go into the meeting. And we kind of go through everything because we never know who's new. They may not have heard it before, but just let everyone know this meeting is being recorded and it's being, you can share it actually on Facebook at facebook.com/every.black. So if you have Facebook, please go there to our address, facebook.com/every.black, and just share it. That really helps get the word out, get the meeting out, not only what we do, but also in your network. And you can raise your hand, your electronic hand, if you'd like to be called upon to say anything or make a comment or ask questions. But please stay on mute in case you so we won't have any background noise or until you have a question or a comment. And when you do have a comment, we ask that you just state your name and location so we know who you are and where you are. But please keep your comments brief and to the point so everyone has a chance to speak. We always start off with a verse, Bible verse, or a word, a scripture that Olivia Robinson's prepared for us. So we'll share that now.
Hi, my name is Olivia Robinson, and I bring you greetings from Cary, North Carolina. Our scripture today is coming from Ecclesiastes 3, verses 1 through 4 from the Amplified Bible. There is a season for everything, and a time for every delight and event or purpose under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot what is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance.
And what I just wanted to cover also again, in case we have anyone that's new. So what is Every Dot Black? We also often get that. And Every Dot Black is actually a support group for entrepreneurs. But it says here, our mission is really to assist, educate, and inspire people to create wealth through entrepreneurship. And we really have a heavy focus on technology, which is why we're offering computer classes now. We've actually got the entire almost the entire schedule for 2023 is up on the website now, but there's going to be more things added. And also, the other part of that is the strategy of global networking. And we do the networking through these mastermind meetings that we have every Monday night. Same Zoom ID, same passcode every Monday night at 8 p.m. And if you want to interact with entrepreneurs in the Caribbean, it's every Tuesday night at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, or if in the Caribbean, at 7 p.m. And you can also interact with entrepreneurs in Africa with Every Dot Black Africa, which is every Thursday at 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time or 8 p.m. Central Africa time. So anyway, that's basically what Every Dot Black is. And what we do is we promote our members through our website, through social media, email blast. I mentioned computer classes for entrepreneurs to help them understand and use the technology they need to run their businesses. And then the mastermind meetings. And then also, we help them create and share podcasts and even streaming TV to get the word out about their businesses. But what is the Joe Dell Dudley Senior Legacy Project? And some of you have heard me say this probably a dozen times before, But I was literally at Mr. Dudley's house when I look at the time. That was actually 3 years ago now. Can't believe it's been that long. But I notice he's got a lot of tapes and cassettes and of speeches and graduations and all types of events that he's been collecting over the last 50 plus years. And so what I did, we've been converting some of these tapes. Now, this is one of the tapes that we converted. And I played this last month too, but I just wanted to share it again in case anyone's new. This is a tape that we converted that is damaged because of age and mold. So it did not convert well. It was unusable. So this is why we're trying to preserve this content. So it's about 30 seconds. I'll go ahead and play that. So I just wanted to play a few seconds of that, but that's what happens if we don't preserve the content. It'll all be like that over time. So that's what we're trying to do is prevent and save this content so that it can be seen and used and learned. People can learn from it for years to come. And so we're preserving all types of content, whether it's on DVDs, VHS tapes, 3/4-inch tapes, photographs, awards, documents, and awards, and then also interviews. We've done over 250 interviews of people either associated with the company or impacted by Mr. Dudley over the years. So the purpose is once we do that, then it'd be preserved over time. It can be shared in libraries or over the internet or in museums and on podcasts or streaming or even streaming TV or websites for people to view and learn from. So that's the whole objective. And again, we have a team that has been helping. And I don't know why I overlooked one name I want to point out under cataloging is Yvette DeVere. She also was helping catalog in the beginning to, I just wanted to mention her, but this is the team of people that have helped over the last 3 years in some way, whether it's cataloging, helping to schedule interviews, video editing, or actually doing the interviews. And also it's helping to get people to sign up for the podcast to raise the funds we need to preserve the content. So this month I thought, this is we just restored a batch of 25 tapes. And this one was about the DCU graduation class spot number 550. And think about that, class 550. I don't know how many total classes there were, but this is class 550. And I was going to have different clips of different things, different tapes, but all of the clips you'll see today came from this one tape. And I thought it would be, give you a good idea if you weren't there, it'd give you a great idea of what a DCU graduation looked like, right? So it's about five clips. They're all about maybe 2 to 5 minutes long in length. But I'm going to play them. And tonight, I want to really get your viewpoint. What do you think about seeing the clips? Is there anything that stands out to you as I play these? And then I'll share my thoughts about it. So.
Now who that trying to be bad? That's basic school, that's basic school, that's hey, what? 2, 3, 4, 5, basic school.
What do y'all think? Any thoughts or comments? It's a small group tonight, so feel free to chime in if anyone has any thoughts or comments after seeing these tapes.
I think it's great. You need a something that's going to jar people, to inspire them, to give them a little rah-rah to your accomplishments. I think it's great. You need something like that. And it's even better when you're in person.
That's not like any graduation I've ever seen.
Well, I was thinking the same thing. They're having a lot of fun. Yeah. And that was just one class, class number 550. Any other thoughts or comments?
Yes, Jimmy, and they are coming in there in that meeting after staying up many nights at 12, 1 o'clock and working too. So they it's a celebration. It's a heartfelt celebration because they've been up late styling hair and listening to instructors. So it's awesome.
Yeah.
Speaking of hair, everybody's head looks good.
Yes.
Well, Jimmy, it's Nelly. Just a little backstory. This actually was a meeting of the basic school. The basic school is students who are learning cosmetology from the beginning. And they attended the graduation of the advanced students who had come from far and near to improve their skills or to learn more or to go to the next level. So this was a meeting of the two levels. And so this education and this inspiration was being shared on two different levels on a weekly basis. Basic school got to come to the graduation, which inspired them to want to first complete their 10 months of training. Mm-hmm. And then to be able to go on and to be able to come back and be a part of a graduation on that second level.
Wow. Do you remember being at this particular one?
Not that particular one. I think I was at another location at that particular time.
Okay.
And Jimmy, in reference to the 550, generally the first week that we had a class, that's class one. So yes, each week got a new number. So the next week would be 551. So for the most part, they started counting way back. I forget exactly when DCU got open, but those are actual weeks. Yes, 550 weeks.
And that was counting advanced classes only. That did not include the basic school.
Oh, yes, correction. That's absolutely correct.
Mm-hmm. So, I mean, that just gives you an idea of the scale, the scope of how many people came through DCU and still coming through DCU. So, yeah. Well, here's another one. I was kind of mesmerized by this one VHS tape as I was going through it. And again, I just took segments of it because the whole thing was much longer. But I just took segments of it. This one's a couple of minutes long, maybe 3 or 4 minutes long. So we'll play this one.
Thank you.
Oh, what do y'all think of that one?
That's like a sorority, a fraternity step show.
Yep.
Right.
Step show.
Mm-hmm. I know. You can't go to DCU if you can't step.
And Jimmy, if I could make a comment too, you see the one, the advanced people, they're in their gowns and caps. Now they have more structured program when they come for the advanced class. That's 550 classes. Those are the advanced. Now these students here, they actually, Dudley teaches how to organize yourself and select, vote in a leader and come up with these routines. Those in white, those routines were not actually at the Dudley camp. They created those themselves.
Mm-hmm.
But Dudley always, the company always, instructors teach how to vote your leader in, just like the advanced class had president, vice president, too, the ones in the cap and gown.
Mm-hmm.
That's part of the Dudley training, how to organize quickly so they can go back to their salon and do the same thing.
Wow. Wow, that's great information. Anyone else, any other thoughts, comments?
Just a comment, Mildred Henry.
Hi, Dr. Henry.
Hi, California. Just want to say that I think that's really great. It's very energizing to have them do the step, to have them do this performance. And I'm enjoying it. You can play more if you got more.
Well,
it's a very good touch. And we, it shows the talent of the students and the participants. I'm impressed. Thank you for sharing.
Absolutely. Yes.
Also, can I say one more thing?
Sure.
Also, if you listen to the words of what they were saying, mm-hmm. you know, they were saying that Dudley is going to change the world today and things like that, you know, so it's not just, they had a message, is what mm-hmm. I'm trying to say. They had a message of unity and a common goal, a vision. This is Michelle from Durham.
Yes, you're so right. You're so right, man. Yes.
And for those that may have just come on, like I said, I was going through these tapes. We just converted a batch of 25. And this one tape was a graduation. And so I thought it would just be a good idea to show what a graduation, a DCU graduation looked like. Again, I can't show the whole thing because of time. So I picked out segments of it. So this is another segment of the... this is a poem, I believe, that a young lady recited, so.
I just have some words of wisdom for you today, and it actually comes from Mr. Dudley's book, I Am Walking by Faith, I Am, I Can, and I Will. And the poem is called Faith. And I offer this to each and every one of you as you go back to your various destinations, because that's what it's gonna take. It's gonna take faith. This is an industry that requires much of it, and so I offer that to you as words of wisdom today, because as you leave here, there are all kind of obstacles that you're going to face. And if you don't hold fast to faith, then you're not going to be able to withstand. Don't let anyone turn you around. Keep your feet on solid ground. As long as you continue to do your best, whatever you do, you'll be a success. You may get discouraged sometimes. You may even want to cry. But always remember to hold your head up high. Sometimes life is full of disappointment. Sometimes it is full of pain. But as long as you keep your faith in God's success, you will surely gain. There have been many mountains I thought I couldn't climb, but I ended up climbing most of them once I made it up in my mind. I have dreamed many dreams that never came true, and when I thought all hope was gone, God stepped in, gave me the will to make me want to keep dreaming on. I have prayed many prayers that went unanswered, even though I was patient and waited so long, but the Lord answered enough of my prayers to keep me praying on. I have trusted so many called friends, and who in the end left me to weep alone, but I have enough true friends to keep me trusting on. I have sown many seeds that fell by the way, seeds that the birds fed upon. But I have enough golden shields in hand to keep me sowing on. I have known the pain of disappointment, and I have gone many days without sun. But I have sipped enough nectar from the roses of life to keep me want to live on. No matter what your gold in life, ladies and gentlemen, no matter what your gold is in life, I'm gonna say that one more time. No matter what your gold is in life, no matter what you want to do, as long as you keep your faith in God, He will surely see you through. Thank you.
So that was a poem that was recited at that particular graduation, and they kind of panned the room so you can see some of the other graduates in their caps and gowns. Now, the young ladies on the right, the one closest to the podium, I think she's the president, and I assume the other one was the vice president. So in part of the video, she spoke, but I didn't put that in her speaking, but she is the president of that particular class. So any thoughts or comments about that? Or
you picked some, Jimmy, again, Nellie, you picked some really good points. That particular segment actually epitomizes it. It really demonstrates that link. That young lady actually was once one of those basic students who sat in the audience in white, going through basic school, learning cosmetology from the beginning. And by the classes of 500, she had graduated from basic school and was now speaking as an instructor for the advanced class.
Wow.
Mr. Dudley is also enjoying this trip down memory lane with us tonight. So he's sitting to my right here and just enjoying those familiar faces from a few years back.
But I think one thing that hit me too is by watching a graduation, really getting a sense of the culture of the school. Like, you know, like Michelle says, she's never seen a graduation like that. You know, but it's their own flair, and also the encouragement that they're giving the students every step of the way. And I've got a few more clips to show you, but encouraging them to, when they go back out, you know, to keep the faith and to work hard, that type of thing. So I really enjoyed it. So I'm going to go ahead and share another.
Jimmy.
Yes.
This is Doc. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
Okay, do you have a minute for me? Do you have a minute for me to make a comment?
Sure. Go ahead. Go right ahead.
I'm enjoying this, and this is just going to take it just a little bit different direction. When I see the program and the work that you, this great work here, this is beautiful. The point I want to make is that I think that when we're trying to sell people, I'm using the word sell, but anyway, the key thing that can move us along with programs like this is that we have to we want to recognize that we can utilize storytelling to move the product. Okay, for example, let me ramble. Let me try to break it down. See, facts tell and stories sell. Okay, so now, why am I bringing this up? Well, the way to influence people is that people, we all think in stories, and that goes. For example, that's why they use parables in the Bible. If you notice, Mr. Dudley, the Walking by Faith book is full of stories. Okay, because the mind, we think in stories. If let's say if I'm deciding to go to Walmart, I'm really thinking I'm gonna go to Walmart. Okay, until my mind read that story, I'm not gonna do anything. Okay, so what we're really doing, we're trying to influence people and work on developing. We're simply trying to develop activities to get people to change the story, because only after they change the story that they tell themselves will they change their behavior. Okay, now. So in business, we utilize two basic types of stories. There are others, but the two basic types. And I want to share those right quickly, because I think it can help you with your program.
Okay.
The first type of story is you develop a product and a company story. So if a company and a business doesn't have a story, it's not going to be successful, because people don't know what it's really about. For example, when you only talk about Mr. Dudley, there's a company and a product story. Mr. Dudley started with $10, okay? He built the company up to millions. He started with a black bag. He sells hair care products through his people. He makes it and he sells it through black people. This whole product story. His products are made fresh. He prays on his products, okay? That's a product story, okay? That just makes people aware of Dudley products, okay? But in order to sell Dudley products, he also utilized something called a field story, F-I-E-L-D, field story. So any successful business must train its people on two types of stories. Okay, now, what we run into problem is that we get excited about our company, a product story, and we just simply tell that, and we wonder why people don't buy from us, okay? Now, the difference is, see, in the company story, I'm gonna make the company and the product the hero. But the person, my customer, when I'm trying to sell them in the field story, I'm gonna make a story, make them the hero. And say, this is what you can do with this. This is what this is gonna do for you. Then they can see themselves buying it, okay? Now I don't wanna spend a lot of time, but I'm trying to show you that you got a beautiful program here, buddy. I haven't been following y'all, but if you develop a company story and a field story, F-I-E-L-D field story, where you make the receiver of the information a hero, showing them what they can do with it. For example, the program with the young ladies danced a moment ago. Okay, mm-hmm. that's a product story, okay? Now, but to sell it to somebody, I will come up with a field story where I'm saying like, now, let me see it. If you recruit some young people to work for you, interns, okay, in order to get them excited about your business, you want to develop routines and have them engaged and things. I'm going to show you what you can do with it. It's always about what you can do, okay? And if you listen to Mr. Dudley, his stories, yeah, he would start out with a company story about I took $10 and made millions of dollars. But if you listen very carefully, he's going to shift that to a you can do more than I can do. You can, are y'all still there?
Mm-hmm.
I think.
Mm-hmm. I'm, yeah, okay. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Okay, in that comes, he's gonna shift that story to you can do better than I can do. You can become a millionaire. My goal is to make 220 millionaires. He shifts that story and make you a hero. So a lot of people don't know why they'd be so excited to be around him, because very subtly, he always makes the person with him a hero. He shifts that story from a product story to a field story. Now, let me go back. I'm rushing through because I don't want to take all your time. To get you to make you understand this, so that when I work with businesses, I always make sure that they develop a company story and a field story and show them how they shift from the I and we do to you and make that person a hero. And once they can see themselves using this, for example, I would make a field story about those young ladies showing a person how they could do that and build their business. Okay, and then it's easy for me to sell them to it because that goes to their subconscious mind. They can see themselves doing that, okay? That's how Mr. Dudley sold the $1 million a day. That's how he will get people going out doing door to door, things like that. He does two different types of stories, okay? Now, most of what we're doing, most business people, what we do, we just do the company story and we just tell people, the customer about that, but the customer's got to figure out how it fits them. And that's why they don't really buy from me. But if you can go and give them a story where they see themselves a hero, it's almost an automatic sale. Now, when I do this, when I talk about the field story, when you look at Jesus, when he talks about the Good Samaritans, when the lady at the well, he goes in that conversation, if you listen to it, you'll see how he shifts from a company story to a field story and tell the lady at the well, if you can do this, it becomes a you language. And Mr. Dudley does that so smoothly, you won't even recognize it, okay? But we got to break it down. When we sell the programs like this, you got your company story, but we keep selling the company story, but the person's got to figure out, how can I use that? And that's where they stall at. But if you would develop a field story, make them heroes, okay? And how you can see that, you watch the commercials on TV, they always will have some customer, somebody that make it to a hero and make it, you see how you can do that. That person becomes you. And when I teach the class, I show them the steps and go through. It's a 5-step process. But master salespeople like Mr. Dudley, they very definitely move from that company story to that hero story for the customer. And the customer see themselves doing it and they're excited about it. Now, so let me just do a little, then I won't take all your time. Let me try to do a little bit more to get you see. For example, when we're in college, and you might, let's see that a young lady might see a guy, she likes him, he's well-dressed, he's well-mannered, So he might ask her for a date, and he goes, they go out on a date. Well, during that date, if that guy, all he does is talk about how many touchdowns he made, and how he's talked about how pretty his car is, and how he like to get his hair cut every 2 weeks. He never talked about her. She's gonna think that's a dump. That date is a no-no. Because all he did was he talked the company story. And that's the same thing we do when we just talk about our product and don't make the person a hero. Now, if he had done a field story, he would have talked about the young lady and how he appreciates her going out with him, how and compliment her on things like that and made her the hero, and she won another date. Because he only talked about himself, she's gonna go back to the dumb and say, look, he's a knucklehead. Okay, that's not a good example, but I'm trying to get you to see. So right. That if we would, in our deliberations, you got a lot of good information, but that's pretty much a company story information. Now, if you can develop some field stories where you make the people, all of us who are looking at it, heroes and how we use it, then it's an automatic sale.
Okay, and so basically, it's very helpful. And so you're saying, what's in it for them, basically, like what to show how it benefits them. So I'm going to say also, as I'm sharing these videos with everyone on the call, think about what Dr. Bailey just said, and how can we collectively turn these videos from a company story to a field story?
Okay, now Jimmy, I'm going a little bit past benefit to them now.
I'm sorry.
I'm saying you make up a story. See, people respond to stories. Listen, Mr. Bell, he's telling stories so that I'm taking y'all, the typical books about benefits and that kind of thing. But no, the person's still going to translate then, okay, because what you want to do is show them what they can do, not what they're going to get. Benefit, I'm just telling you what you're going to get. I want to show you what you can do with this.
Okay.
Notice Mr. Bell is always saying you can do more. He's always do. That's the trick.
Okay.
Take those, you got to translate those. That's why Jesus used a parable about the Good Samaritan. He's putting those into do. Okay, when he left his disciples, they go and do. So that the trick is with these field stories, you want to show the person what they can do as results. And then it's just automatic when they see themselves doing it. And their subconscious mind say, yeah, I got to have this because you make them see it. That's what the commercials do in a case like that. So not just the benefit, go past the benefits, translate those into something they do. Always make a story about what they do, then they'll buy from you.
Okay.
Okay, that's enough for me.
I think it's very good information, very good advice. And I think that's something that we can all use no matter what kind of business we have. But really though, I really would, as everyone's watching this, think about, if you can, think about how we can turn this into a field story, not benefit right. Field story. And also, I say, think about it too for yourselves, like with your own businesses.
Excellent, excellent, excellent.
Think about that as well. So, no, this is good information. And for those that don't know, Dr. Bailey has been with Mr. Dudley for quite a while, but he's also the dean of business at, was it Winston State, Salem?
My last job, teaching job, was Winston-Salem State University, the great
right.
So, Rams, yeah.
So if you don't know him, then he knows what he's talking about, is what I'm trying to say. He definitely knows what he's talking about.
But check it out. Check me out. Look at the commercials on TV and see if they don't do that to you. And as you read Walking by Faith, begin to think of it in terms now of company story and field stories and see how Mr. Dudley, all through the book, he's shifting. And the book is about stories about all those stories about me and all the people in the book. Those are field stories. He's showing you what those people can do.
Mm-hmm.
It's all about, so we have, and that's the trick. Ordinary people gonna do this, try to sell about benefits. Then the person still gotta figure it out, so they gonna hesitate on you. But when you show what they can do, they can move right into that sale, and they can, okay, now I can see what I can do with this. That kind of thing. But that means we have to stretch our back. But then as we're doing it, like you're saying, I can be thinking about how I can use it in my business so that every Sunday we come on, we look at this, but now, how can I use this and do something with it? And Mr. Dudley, Jesus, all the great leaders, that's what they're going to be talking about. Do what you can do, what you can do. That's the field story. Okay, that's enough for me today. I didn't mean to interrupt y'all, throw y'all off, but like, that's where you make your money at, okay?
Okay. Okay. No, we appreciate it. We always appreciate you coming on, Dr. Bailey. I've got a few more videos to share with you. This next one, I think this is it's a portion of the keynote speaker for this particular graduation class. So I'm going to share
that. Life can be displayed in two different ways. And that is, you can live life abundantly by serving and giving and sharing. Am I making sense? Or you can take your life away by being disobedient. Am I making sense? Not obeying the law and the rules. Am I making sense? So this is what came up on my heart to say this afternoon. And I want to say just what God has given me, because I haven't had a chance to think of what I would say. So I would just want to move myself out of the way and let God have his way. And you don't hear me now. Am I making any sense here? Am I making sense? I want to get out of the way. Oh, and I'm grateful for my life. And I'm grateful for those who are around me that who live a life as well. Oh, I think that Mr. and Mrs. Dudley live a beautiful life. Some of the most beautiful lives from those two people that tread the way for the cosmetologists and always doing some denying themselves, trying to make things better for us. Am I making sense? Lose sleep and time and everything else for it to be better for us. Because we don't have anybody to lead us. We are in bondage. Am I making sense? We are still in bondage, and we need somebody. See, God sent Moses to lead the people out of bondage. Am I making sense? So we as a race need somebody to lead us where? Out of bondage, not of poverty. Am I making sense? Because it doesn't make any sense in the world for us as a race. And we live and have our being. We lay down at night and go to sleep without a thought. Wake up the next morning without a thought. Who do we think enabled us to put our clothes on? And we make it across the busy street without having an accident or getting in any kind of trouble. Am I making sense? Who but a God would do that for us? And there's something wrong whenever we live in the world and everybody triumphs with a lot of property and a lot of money and a lot of stuff, and we always behind living from paycheck to paycheck. It's a sin and unforgivable for us to have as much money as we get in our hands and never have nothing. It is something wrong with that kind of life. Am I making sense? It is something wrong with that. We got to stop and check out ourselves. Am I making sense? What is wrong? Why I can't prosper? You know, God put us here to grow and to develop. He put us here to have goals and plans. Look, let me tell you something. If we're the type of person that's going to have egotisticism, am I making sense? We're going to be a gossiper. We look to live on worldly possessions. Am I making sense? Having a good time, partying, clubbing all the time. And still, when we get through doing that, we're looking for somebody to always give us something. God put us here so we could grow and develop. He didn't put us here for a handout. He wants to work by the sweat of our brow. Am I making sense? He don't want nobody to give us nothing. He wants you to work until the day is done. When you work until the day is done, you enjoy the blessing that God sent you. You're supposed to give unselfishly. Am I making sense? You're supposed to plan unselfishly. And when you plan, you're supposed to dream it. And if it's for the people, God will give it to us.
Well, as you can hear, she gets worked up quite a bit. And actually, when I started playing that, I should have stopped. And just also two things I want to see, which if anyone had any thoughts. One, if you had any thoughts about what Dr. Bailey just shared with us. And also, what are your thoughts about this video clip that I shared here of this class's keynote speaker for the class? Any thoughts or comments about either what Dr. Bailey shared with us or about this segment here?
Yes, about this segment, if I might there, Jimmy, that was Ms. Irene Parson, one of the top instructors. She's known all over the country now. She was one of the top instructors. And right there, she'd recently overcome cancer and come back strong.
Wow.
And her two daughters and her son and her husband worked for Dudley Products.
Wow.
She was just awesome, awesome lady. And Jimmy, each time I see a video, I have to just realize without you, lot of these pictures would never have been seen again. So I really, really, each time I see a video, I feel grateful for you being here. Thank you.
Well, I didn't create them. I just dug them up. But the people that created them, I think they get the credit. So.
Well, I'm glad you did some digging, and you did a lot of it when I saw you.
Well, thank you. Anyone else? Any other thoughts, comments? Well, one thing I just want to share, one thought I had going through this, is that God is referenced throughout the graduation ceremony. You know, it's almost like church. It's a feeling, and when I'm listening to her, I feel like I'm in church.
That was her.
Yeah.
That's true, Jimmy. And this is Nancy from Chattanooga. That's very true. And it the whole program, the whole element is God-centered. And you have continued that with our meetings, because it's like a church fellowship. You've got a speaker, which is our mastermind speaker, and then we have fellowship, and then we network. So it is a continuation of this very element.
You're right. That's Dudley Products, right there in a nutshell.
Mildred Henry. I agree with Nancy. This is what I've been thinking ever since I joined the group. That what has impressed me is it seems to be rooted, the whole movement is rooted in a religious belief that we will be successful, that God is our maker and expects us to be successful. And that's one thing I've always been impressed with Dr. Dudley, is that at every meeting that I happen to have attended or heard him speak, it was always a religious background. A strong belief in God and the fact that we will be successful. So I thank you with Nancy. This is something that has impressed me all along the way, and I hope we will keep that belief and that religious belief that God is behind the movement and it will be successful. We will be successful because of our strongly. Thank you.
And I have to say too, when we started our Everyday Black meeting, mastermind meetings, it wasn't by accident. I mean, I literally figured it worked for Mr. Dudley. It worked for S.B. Fuller. So we purposely, you know, it's not exactly the same, but the core elements are the same. So yeah, I figured if it worked for them, like, just continue it on. They've got the recipe. I don't have to figure it out. Just duplicate what they did.
Hey, Jimmy, it's Dr. Yes. Harris here.
Hi, Dr. Harris.
How are you today?
Good.
Mr. Dudley, I you know, just watching this, really, I wish that the young people could see that this was. There's so many people that have no idea that a man, Mr. Dudley, his wife, Mr. Fuller, that Black men and women were building businesses, building schools. You know, I don't know if there's any school left now that being run in the way that Mr. Dudley and created this vision. And so I take my hat off to you, Jimmy, because so many people, if you think about Mr. Fuller and those who went before him, I don't know that anybody ever did that. So their words are lost, you know, in the eternal dustbin of history. But what you've done here, and I'm just glad to be a part of it and to see it, is to really document the journey of a giant, the journey of a man who had a vision and worked hard to make that vision manifested. I remember staying there in the motel there on the Dudley grounds in the cafeteria, and I mean, he literally created a city. And right now, I don't know that there's anything comparable. I don't know that there's anybody that even has that type of vision or the commitment to do it. So one, I take my hat off to Mr. Dudley as an old friend and as a real trailblazer. And I take my hat off to you, Jimmy, and everybody in this group who's made this happen. I, I saw it developing in the very beginning, but what you have done here is incredible and needs to go on, and you know, some funding behind it and putting it together as part of a major museum of Black entrepreneurship and what is possible. Back to you, Jimmy.
Thank you.
Jimmy.
Yes, and then I see Michelle Taylor has her hand raised.
Oh, go ahead, Michelle. Go ahead, Michelle.
No, you, well, okay. I was gonna talk about you. I was gonna talk about what Dr. Bailey said about using it in our business. And I was thinking that maybe the cosmetologists who have a beauty salon, you know, a lot of times you have a television on while you're working and you have the stories playing, you know, or something, I don't know, mindless to keep your client entertained. But what about if beauty salon owners and barbershops played Dr. Dudley's tapes, you know, played the Legacy Project in the salon, so, you know, they would understand that this is a movement, this is buying Black, you know, all any message that they would like to highlight. Is that what you're talking about, Dr. Bailey, changing it to a field story?
Exactly right, because that's how you get people to change. You change the story. If you look at Jesus, that's just what he did. Just he kept changing our story and letting us see, no, this is the story. Heaven is like this. When they talked to him about what is heaven like, he told them about the five talents. Does people understand that? Yeah. But also, I could use what she just did several ways. For example, if I was teaching about how to get people to do a field story, I could use this right here, Ms. Irene's presentation. Notice how she started out talking about Mr. and Mrs. Dudley. And then, when she picked it up and got emotional, she started saying, you can do this, you can do this. See, she went from the company to what the person can do.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that I could use that to train people how to come up with a field story. So this is what you want to do. Then I could use that then to go into what Michelle just did. So now, okay, so this is what this series is about, how you can get people to move and change, because if you don't get them to change the story, they're not going to change. Okay. Then we talked about, for example, the movement. Okay. So we mentioned the word movement, but then, okay, the question would be then, okay, so how do I do a movement? And what is a movement? And what do I do? Well, Mr. Dudley's whole legacy is about a movement, but we could take time to explain a person out. And doing a movement, what you want to do is you want to identify a problem that people are working on and get them to say you're going to help them with the problem and nudge and lead with the problem that they're working on, not with the product. For example, Mr. Dudley built a business on a movement, and the movement was cosmetologists are being misused because other companies get them to sell products and then introduce to customers. Then they take the product, put it in the stores, and lead a cosmetologist without anything. So you said, now that's the problem, but I'm going to help you. Dudley Products Company is going to help you solve that. We're going to fight that problem. So then you come and work with me. So what he did then, by moving to a movement, if he had labeled the product, he would just been like any other company. We got a good relaxer. Well, everybody got a good relaxer, okay? But no, he didn't lead with the product. He made a movement where this is the problem we're trying to solve. So you would teach people. So now if you want to build your business, you want to learn how to build a movement. So why I want to build a movement? Well, if you lead with the product, let's talk about your product. All you do is create loyal customers. If you create a movement, you create supporters. They'll stay with you when you don't have products, in a case like that. So the reason Dudley Products, you can see it right now, why he was successful over many years, Mr. Dudley created a movement. If he had just been dealing with a product, he'd have probably been out of business just a long time ago, but he took it to the level of movement. And the difference is, what makes these tapes so great, you learn how to build your business whereby you're just not building a business and competing with everybody or a product, whereby you just build a lower customers. If you create a movement, you're getting supporters who will help you spread the word, help you build that business. And that's the difference between a lower customer and a supporter. A customer, once somebody's come up with a good product, they're gone. And supporter stays with you through thick and thin. That's the secret sauce for Dudley and the whole idea of how the movement. They can learn this from the state once we explain to them what a movement is, the components of it, and how to do it. So all you gotta do is look at this tape and you'll see how to do that. And you'll build your business with a movement, you'll be able to go and start with $10 like Mr. Dudley, blah, blah, blah. You see how that works?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I talk. I don't, but yes, Marcel, but that's it, you know. Not the baby. Y'all know I'm a talker, okay.
Yeah, did I hear someone else want to make a comment, or?
Doesn't it just make sense to anybody?
Oh, it does,
yeah,
to me.
Yeah, well, we did.
Absolutely, though. Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But you know, Jimmy, there's a group that's putting together a museum of Black entrepreneurs. And I think that they reached out to me and I had recommended Mr. Dudley. And so I'm going to pass your name on along because
okay, please do.
they want to really take it in a bigger context of that this is a historical moment. This is a historical, it's almost like when you go to Rome and you see the ruins of the Parthenon, you stand there and you go, my God, 2000 years ago, people were doing these kind of incredible things. When you see these videos and the work that Mr. Dudley is doing, it's so important to, especially to young Black people, to see that men, Black men, were able to do this in a time that was much more challenging than it is right now on a racial perspective. Mm-hmm. And still they were able to succeed. And so it's bigger than we really think. It's really a historical perspective that should be preserved and shared. And I'll be quiet now.
Please do pass my name along. I would love to speak with this group.
Jimmy, this is Dudley.
Mm-hmm. Oh, hi, Mrs. Dudley.
Hello, Miss Dudley.
Hello. I do appreciate everything that you and all of your staff and volunteers are doing to put this project together. It is just phenomenal. And I'm just looking forward to seeing it grow more and more, that we're able to incorporate more people that we hadn't even considered or hadn't thought about or hadn't remembered that would come along and help to push this project as well. So I'm very grateful to you and all of your helpers, all of the little elves that are pushing and working with this project. I'm very grateful and I'm thankful.
Well, thank you
so very much.
Thank you. We need to thank you from day one because you and Mr. Dudley put it together all together. And so really, that's right. Thank you. Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
I've got, I think, one more clip to share with you that from this graduating class of 550, graduating class number 550. And
hey, Jimmy, yes. I was on Mr. Dudley makes a statement. I was on mute, so he wanted to share a couple ideas from me with you.
Okay.
Well, I'm just thankful for all the people that really come together to make all this happen. It's just really exciting. For all of you that's doing this extra job, it's special. So this is good. Because people need to know that we haven't just sit back and not doing anything. We're really striving to make a better difference in the world in which we came in. And it makes me feel real good. And it shows people what can be done. And when I started, it was not as excited to get going. But now it's challenged, but it's so much better. So we need to just really push. And it's really great.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Dudley.
Yeah, thanks everyone. And actually, I literally woke up with an idea yesterday, and literally that has been on my mind. And Dr. Bailey, I'm going to call you. I want to talk to you about my idea that I had. I don't know why. I literally woke up with a thought to really help get this message out. And not only this message, but some other things as well. So
that's the way the Holy Spirit works, Jimmy. God is working through you. So just let it work, man. Let it work. Yeah. So I'm available. Call me anytime, but let it work. The Spirit works. Holy Spirit works through us much more intelligent than we are. Just let it work, because look what you've done so far. Let it work. I'm here. Let me just give me a call.
Okay, I will do. This is the I think it's the last clip from this graduating class. And well, I'm going to go ahead and play this. This one's a little longer, maybe like 6 minutes, but I think you'll enjoy it.
I tell you the truth, it has been a wonderful, wonderful, inspiring experience to have you all come here this week. And as it was mentioned earlier, you've had tremendous challenges. And there's been tremendous challenges around here, but somehow or other, persevered. Madam President spoke that fact that it was all for a purpose, it was all previously ordained for you to be here at this period. Give yourselves a great round of applause. And we just want to tell you, there's a caption in this, I think it was so appropriate, on the last page, which says, congratulations. There's a scriptural reference given here. Therefore, brethren, be even more diligent to make your call and election sure. For if you do these things, you will never stumble. 2 Peter 1:10. And I think that you all have come here this week, and you certainly have made preparations to keep qualifying yourself for those new dimensions that you've never been before. And when you get back home, certainly take advantage of the opportunity that has been granted to you and shared with you this week, because you certainly stand out ahead of the rest. Seize the opportunity, and I guarantee you, God will have all of these blessings that you won't even have the room enough to receive if you keep your hearts right and keep your mind stayed on Him. Glory! And we want to sing a little song for you as well, let you know how much we love you, how much we appreciate you, and how much we're going to miss you when you're gone. And we do deeply love you very much, and we want you all to remember that. May God bless you again. May heaven shine all over you. Thank you very much. Message with you everywhere, and tell the world at DCU we really care. Our hearts are filled with love that overflows. Hello,
And we will wonder where you are. And we'll wonder what you do. If you're somewhere seeking your dreams, your love and happiness too. If you put faith in your heart, God will make your dreams come true. Oh, won't you please remember DCU? You know, you see them flying all over this country, in fact, all over this world, spreading the love for the cosmetologist. And I stand here to tell you this afternoon, there is no greater display of love, better than displayed by those Dudleys. I think we should give them a great round of applause for putting this place together. Thank you, thank you, thank you very much. Go, and we will wonder where you are, and we'll wonder what you do if you're somewhere seeking your dreams of love and happiness too. If you put faith in your heart, God will make your dreams come true. Won't you please remember? Thank you all. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Might have noticed the tissues being passed around. And time he sang that at most graduations, and they'd always have two boxes of tissue. One of each side of the room to pass around.
Right.
But that one reminds me, this is Michelle again, that reminds me of my HBCU, Hampton University, that I went to. It was like a family feeling. And, you know, it was something that you don't experience out in the world, where everybody is rooting for you, rooting for your success, and in your corner, you know, and it's like a really safe space. And then when you go out into the world, it's just warning you, you know, it's not going to be the same. I think that's why all the handkerchiefs came out, or the tissues came out, because, you know, I don't know, that I have my tissues too.
Michelle.
Yes, sir.
This is Doc. You know, I went to Tougaloo, so I can relate to that feeling. But like, here's a field story off of just what happened. Once you get a person to change, to come up with a new story from an old story, the way you lock it in is using rituals like singing, repeating covenants, things like that. So that's part of when they went through that class at DCU, they had a new experience. So we want to leave with a new story. Then we lock it in with the rituals. You see it in our churches. When we're going through, so why is the preacher having to stand up and do these things like that? So in your business, as you're moving people, developing new movements, and what you can learn from this great series of tapes and videos that Mr. Jimmy has here, you can learn how to get people to move to a new story and lock it in using rituals like this. So there will be another field story I could sell off of this on like that. And that's what they did at our schools. You can see religious groups do it. The Army does it. They got those soldiers singing. And in 6 weeks, they got them when they turn them 18-year-olds into people who go out and sacrifice their lives, because they use old story to new story and lock it in with rituals. And that's what, this is just a great example of that. And we could dissect that and show people. And this is why this thing is so valuable, to show you how to build your organization and get people to change, because the only way you can get them changed is come up with new stories. And this tape shows you how very effectively Mr. and Mrs. Dudley did it, that kind of thing. So I could use that to show that process. And again, you see that Hampton, all the great leaders know that. So we could use that to teach our people this and how we can move forward. And we can even kill that whole thing about Black folk can't work together, because it's just knowing how, in the Dulles, this will show us how it's done. Okay, that was just a tidbit I threw in to show you. I'm still on my field story versus company story. It's showing how it works out.
Great.
Okay, thank you.
Any other thoughts, comments about the...
Just one quick one, if I may. Under that podium there, the shelf for the Bible, it was always there. The Christian priest was such a part of the teaching there in the classes. And one comment we often got from people from all over the country, and they came from California, the islands, everywhere. They said, I feel like Mr. Dudley had such a spirit on that campus that they would say, I feel like I'm on holy ground. We got that comment from so many people. Called that one, someone just mentioned that a family feeling. It was very strong, very powerful. And that was the driving force of Dudley product, was the spirit of the people. Now, we had about 100 people, employees on the campus right there. So we had a lot of Dudley employees here.
Wow.
Let me correct that. That was 100 and some.
100 and some. I didn't catch the last part of that. Mr. Milburn, you said 100 and maybe he's not available. I don't know. Anyway, I'm going to kind of, we took a little longer than I thought, but I think you all got quite a bit out of this between the videos and just the discussion and the lessons, like how we can use this. So one of the things I just said, we just want to share this with others on our social media, invite to share the story with the organization. Again, we're more than willing. I know Kim and myself and Nellie, I'm sure Michelle, we'd be glad to speak to your group or organization about this. And of course, we want to get people to subscribe to the podcast at joeldudleysr.com. That's how you can get there. I'm going to go through this kind of quickly, just to mention too that Brother Sam Tate, I don't know if he's on the call today, but he's been playing the commercials on the Gospel Gems, his network. And also, this is important. I've been saying that Mr. Lafayette Jones is putting together a urban call just about this project. And it's going to be in the OTC Beauty Magazine, which is a national publication. And actually, we've been working on it for about the last month. And it's almost ready, probably another month or so, it's going to be ready. But one of the things we want to do, we want to put the photos of some of the people that, some of you. So if you have a nice photo, if we don't have a nice photo of you, we need some quality photos, headshots of you to put in this publication before it goes out the door. If we don't have a photo, we won't be able to include you in the next publication, but we will be putting photos of a lot of the people. We can't do everyone. Because there's so many folks, but we will be putting up photos of a lot of people in this next one of the upcoming publications, Urban Call, and that's going to be on the OTC Beauty Magazine, which is an international publication, beauty publication. Just a reminder too that we have t-shirts and hoodies for sale, and if you're interested in a t-shirt or hoodie, you can email me. I think the t-shirts are $30, and I think that the Dudley hoodie is for $50, and they're actually both nice t-shirt and the hoodie. And the other thing, this is brand new, the story of Little Joe, which was written by Ella Wilson and illustrated by Michelle Nicole Taylor. And so this is hot off the press. So if you want a book, you can reach out to Ella or myself. They're selling for $30, and we'll be glad to get you one. And actually, it's the story of Mr. Dudley's childhood. So it's not about the business years, but the things that happened during his childhood. And if you want more information about that, I'm sure Ella and Michelle can give you more information about that. And that's the back of the, that's the first was the cover, and this is the back cover of the book. And again, just a reminder, There's three different levels, the silver, the gold, and the platinum. The silver is $10 a month where you can hear the interviews, $25 and platinum. The gold and platinum makes you a charter member, and you can also hear the speeches. And also, just a reminder too, that you can actually get your content, your commercial on streaming television, reaching over 440 million people now in 128 countries. And this is one of the ads that we posted on streaming.
You've been looking for a place to grow your talent. Dudley Beauty College is the place for you. We offer programs in cosmetology, nail technology, aesthetics, barbering, natural hair, instructor training, desirology, and trichology. Our graduates are ready for the world. What are you waiting for? Bring your talents to a place they can thrive. Dudley Beauty College Chicago. Call or visit today. DudleyBeautyCollegeChicago.com.
And I got one more to share with you.
At DCU, you will experience classroom and practical application. Your future is waiting on you, and the path of your success starts at Dudley Cosmetology University at 519 South Elm Street.
And I think that's about all I had to share with you today. But yeah, that was the last one. But any last thoughts or comments at all from anyone? Or just a reminder that beginning in 2023, we'll go back to meeting on the last Sunday of the month. We just kind of got thrown off a little bit because of Thanksgiving and Christmas. But January 29th, 2023 at 7 p.m. And we'll send out the e-vites like we always do. And we need to, I say we, because we all need to work on that company story and field story. See if we can't get something a little more concrete. Any last thoughts?
I'll be in touch this week again. You know, we like to play phone tag, Jimmy. Okay. I will be calling you. I have a couple of projects I want to go over with you.
Okay.
Related to our program here, of course. Thank you.
All right.
Good job, Jimmy. Proud of you.
Oh, thank you. I always say it's not just me. Nellie and Michelle and Kim, they've been every step of the way. They've been right there with me.
Yes.
And we've had some other volunteers helping in, but like Mr. Reed did a lot of interviewing, and Dr. Beverly did a lot of interviewing, and just along the way, a number of people have really stepped up to help. We just keep working it.
Absolutely.
So, well, I'm going to stop there unless anyone else has any other things to share. Hope you enjoyed the videos and. From yesteryear, brought back some memories for some and exposed things for others. And again, I really do appreciate Dr. Bailey, the words of wisdom you shared with us about the field story and the company story.
You're welcome. God bless you all.
Okay.
Well, great program. Thank you, Danny.
All right. Let's say going once, going twice.
Until next time.
All right.
Good night, everybody.
Good night, Michelle. Good night, everybody. Blessings. Love y'all.
Good night.
Take care.
Good night, everybody.
I'll be back.
Everybody.
Good night.
Good night.